So today we're going to have a very, very deep look into an onion cell, or actually several onion cells, which you happen to see over here. And specifically, I'd like to show you the movement that's going on inside an onion cell. Those little dots, these are vesicles. Hello and welcome, Microbehunter here. And yes, onions do belong to the beginner's specimens. I say beginners because they're so easy to prepare. However, I would say that if you actually look at them in very close detail, they have a lot of interesting things to discover. And I think for that, in that sense, onions cells are a little bit underrated, if you allow me to use that term. Yes, I'm preparing now an onion slide, and at high magnifications, I'm usually using 600 to 1000 times, we can see that there are many tiny little moving dots inside the onion cells. And what I've done here is I've recorded the videos over the course of several minutes, and then in time lapse, I've increased the speed around 30 to 50 times. And this is where we see those tiny little vesicles, these are the dots, to be moving along inside the cell, almost like, you know, like on a highway, I would say. And there are also regions in the cell where you see that there are those vesicles are not there. Now, the movement is not well visible when you just have an overview image here. But when you zoom in and when you actually magnify it quite a bit bigger, then those vesicles start to become apparent. Now, some of you might wonder a little bit about the colors. For example, this one over here is blue, but sometimes the colors can also be different. And I have to reassure you is these are not the natural colors, but rather I changed the colors around using my video editing software. So right now I've given it a slightly blue tint, but other colors are possible as well, as I'm going to just show you in a second. Now, for example, blue over here, and then over here a little bit yellowish, greenish, and yeah, you can play around with it all the things that you want. You can also zoom in a little bit like right now, or do some rotations. All of these things are possible in the video editing software, but the natural color of those onion cells is actually colorless. Yes, even though these are plant cells, there are no chloroplasts inside the onion, and therefore what you actually get is you get a black white image. And for this reason, to make the contrast a little bit better, I added a little bit of color. But what we are really interested in is are those tiny vesicles. And one of the things that you might notice is that those vesicles, those dots, those tiny moving dots, are not everywhere in the cell, but they can be found quite a bit compressed to the side of the cell, near the cell wall. And this is because the central part of the cell contains a large vacuole. Now, the vacuole is a structure inside a plant cell, which is for storage. For example, water and minerals are stored inside the vacuole. And other things that you can see are those the nucleus, and those are the round oval structures. And the nucleus contains the DNA of the cell. So by simply zooming in quite a bit, what we can see is that there is quite a bit of biological activity going on inside a cell. And after all, movement is one of the central characteristics of life. Now, you might wonder a little bit, what do those vesicles transport? And a larger variety of substances. For example, vesicles might transport important components, maybe for the cell wall, for making a new cell wall, or cell membranes even, and so on. So they contain maybe enzymes and a variety of different substances. And over here, also quite interesting, I could see that two cells were touching each other, but they seem to be connected a little bit as well. So the cell wall did not entirely separate them. And if you look carefully, you can see that some of those vesicles are actually able to pass from one cell to the next cell. So I personally like a lot the fact that such a simple specimen like an onion actually has so many things to reveal. If you want to try this yourself, then do make sure that you take very steady videos or pictures. I've for example, taken over the course of 5 to 10 minutes the videos, and then I was speeding it up quite a bit. But you are able to see the movement already without a time lapse. Here, for example, those vesicles now can be found not on the side, but towards the top of the onion. So actually, they're still compressed to the side, but I'm having now a top view on those vesicles, and you can see that their movement is not entirely random either. And here in this video clip, you can see that the central part of the cell actually does not contain so many of those vesicles, because most of them are compressed to the side where you see the cell wall. As a matter of fact, those onion cells are indeed very large. If you use a strong magnifying glass, then you're also able to see them, the elongated structure of those cells. So I really highly encourage you to grab yourself an onion and put it under the microscope if you have not already done so. If you want to know how to prepare this, if you want to get another video, then I already made a video 3 years ago, which actually belongs to one of the most popular videos of my YouTube channel. So have a look here if you want to know a little bit more. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye bye.